Yes, one of you, please confirm if my voice is clear. You're able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, okay, right. So, Ri1, as we discussed, Ri1 is Vi divided by Ib1. Okay, Vi divided by Ib1. This is the input resistance of first stage. Okay, to get the overall input resistance, we have to consider this resistance in parallel with the input resistance of first stage. Okay, input resistance of first stage we got HIE. To get the overall input resistance, this HIE in parallel with this resistance we have to consider. So, HIE in parallel with 9.09, right? 9.09 in parallel with HIE. HIE is 1. So, the result that you will get, okay, is the overall input resistance, okay, overall input resistance RI. Okay, so this is the value for RI. Next, here, what is the other thing asked in question? AV. Okay. What else is asked? AV. How to get AV? As discussed, AV is V0 by VI. Okay. So, what is V0 here? Tell me, what is V0 from this? Now see, current flowing is like this, isn't it? Always current flows in loop. So here is current is flowing here, current is flowing in anti-clockwise direction. Here the current is flowing in anti-clockwise direction. Now when I say V0, I should take current flowing in downward direction, right? The current flowing in upward direction is HFeIb2. So, the current flowing in downward direction will be what?
Minus HFeIb2.
Very good. Minus HFeIb2. So, what will V0 be equal to?
Minus HFeIb2 into 3K.
Very good. V0 will be equal to minus HFeIb2 into 3K. Okay. Next, we have to see question, what is HFE given? Okay, so same old process, you have to just carefully and be, you have to carefully implement, that's it. HFE, what is the question in HFE? Okay, in question, what is the HFE given? Okay, 50, right? In the question, HFE is given 50. So, 50 multiplied by 3K, how much is that? 50 into 3, 150. Okay. 50 into 3 is 150. And K, kilo is 10 power 3. Okay. So, what we are doing, we are just seeing question. In question, HFE given 50. 50 into 3, 150. Okay. K is 10 power 3. Ib2 as it is, minus sign as it is. Okay. So, V0 we got in terms of Ib2. Looking at the circuit, we know I can get Vi in terms of Ib1. So, already I got V0 in terms of Ib2. If I get Ib2 in terms of Ib1, then I will easily get an expression for voltage gain. Okay. Where is the part of circuit which gives me relation between Ib1 and Ib2? See, here only Ib1, here only Ib2. If I want relation between Ib1, Ib2, I have to see here. Okay. Nothing to remember. Just think, right? Think and do. Okay. So, I have to see here if I want Ib2, right? See, current leaving this junction is HFeIb1. Current entering this junction will be what?
Current. Minus HFeIb.
Very good. Okay. Now, that you can observe, that you can apply because there is no branching here. Okay, right? There is no branching. Then only I can apply, because this is single line, single line. Suppose something else is connected, I cannot use this. Okay, here this is single line, means current leaving this path is HFE IB1. Current entering this junction, current entering this junction will be minus HFE IB1. Okay, so now we can use current division rule. Current entering two resistance, okay, is divided in the two resistance in such a way that this current, which is IB2, will be equal to total entering current multiplied by other branch resistance. Other branch resistance is 3.15k. Okay, so this current means current in HIE will be total current entering multiplied by other resistance by sum of the two resistances. So what is IB2 in terms of HFE IB1? Please answer. What is IB2 from this current division rule? Again, current division rule also not new, same old thing. Okay, so for this circuit, only thing, nothing you have to remember. Circuit also given in question. If it is a problem, circuit is given. If theory, you have to remember circuit. So problem point of view, nothing to remember. Theory point of view, this circuit you have to remember. Equivalent circuit of transistor you have to remember. Okay. Anyway, so what is IB2 in terms of IB1? Please answer. Current division rule. Current entering the terminal is minus HFE IB1. Okay. Right. So, current in this branch means IB2 will be equal to total current entering into 3.15 divided by 3.15 plus HIE. Okay. Current division rule, please answer. IB2 is equals to minus HFE
IB1 into 3.15K by 3.15K plus HIE.
Very good, correct answer. So, IB2 is equals to minus HFE IB1 into 3.15K divided by 3.15K plus HIE. Okay, current division rule. Current in one branch is equal to total. Current in one branch is equal to total current into other resistor by sum of the two resistors. Okay. You might have studied this in your 12th standard current division rule. Right. Earlier also previous problems we have discussed many times. Should not forget. So, very good. Correct answer. Now, HIE already given in question. How much HIE? 1K. 1 kilo ohm. HIE is 1 kilo ohm given in the question. Okay. So, 3.15K plus 1K, 4.15K. Okay. In the denominator. Remaining part as it is. HFE given in the question 50. HFE given in the question 50. So, that one we are taking. Now let us simplify. Kilo, kilo cancel. Kilo is 10 power 3. 10 power 3, 10 power 3 cancel. If you simplify, you are getting this IB2 in terms of IB1. Okay. Right. Problem is somewhat easier because you can multiply, divide, whatever operation, get a single number. Right. Derivation, you have lot of variables, but technique is the same. Okay. You have done your past 12th standard. It means you are master, right, in all these calculations and derivations. Okay. Next. Now I got IB1 in terms of, now I got IB2 in terms of IB1. Okay. V0 I got in terms of IB2. Next, what I should do? Anybody answer? Next, I can substitute that one here, isn't it? That IB2 what I got, I can substitute here. Okay. So, equation 2 in equation 1, this IB2 which I got, I am substituting here. So minus 150 into 10 power 3 as it is, minus 150 into 10 power 3 as it is, into IB2 we have. So into IB2 as it is, I am taking here. Okay, right. So what we are doing here, IB2 in terms of IB1 we got, V0 in terms of IB2 we got, that IB2 we are replacing with this, whatever IB2 we got. Okay. Now, simplify, minus into minus, plus. So the overall result is plus 150 into 37.95. If you do, it will be 5693. Today only I have done. Okay. You can check this calculation, right? 10 power 3 as it is. 10 power 3 we are taking as it is. IB1 we are taking as it is. V0 we got. Okay. V0 in terms of IB1 we got. If I get VI also in terms of IB1, my result I will get very easily. So let us see VI. Here already VI, RI1 we discussed as VI by IB1. So what will VI be from this relation? Answer, anybody answer?
RI1 into IB1.
Yes, VI is RI1 into IB1. RI1 is how much? Here, what is the value? 1 kilo ohm.
1 kilo.
Yes. So, VI, I can write it as 1 kilo ohm multiplied by IB1. So, VI, I can write it as RI into IB1, which is 1 kilo ohm multiplied by IB1. Okay. Now, see, what I am doing, I am smartly thinking and I am getting V0 also in terms of IB1, VI also in terms of IB1. Okay. It could be anything. It could be IB1. If you can get in terms of some other, suppose IB2, also no problem, but you should cancel out the common and you should get a result. That is the idea. So, smartly we are getting V0 in terms of IB1, VI also in terms of IB1. Now, I can directly take the ratio, I will get the result. Okay. So, AV, V0 by VI, V0 is this, VI is this. If I take ratio, observe, 10 power 3 IB1, 10 power 3 IB1 common. So, when I do V0 by VI, the common term in division common term will cancel out, isn't it? So, this will cancel, 5693 divided by 1, 5693, okay? So, voltage gain AV we got, okay? Voltage gain AV. Next, what is the next task? Based on question, what is the next task? Please answer. Based on the question, next what we should calculate? RIV completed. R0 we said we will do last. AV we completed. Next what?
AVS.
AVS. Okay. Yes. AVS. See, why am I telling like this? Because there is nothing to remember. You see the question, as per question, you keep solving. Okay, right? Isn't it? Say, daily you are walking from one place to another place, right? Do you remember all the road? Isn't it? You don't remember. You know, you remember only the junctions. It is the same. We know the junctions. Given the circuit, first junction is AC equivalent, right? The second junction, okay, is replace the transistor by approximate model. Third junction, you know the definitions for RA, AV, AI, so on. Okay. Right. Then apply KVL, KCL, voltage division rule, current division, get the expressions. It is the same. I should, isn't it? You are traveling from college to home. Suppose you are driving by yourself. You are not remembering the entire road. What is the left side shop, right side shop? Are you by-hearting everything? You are not by-hearting. Just wherever the turnings, you remember the turnings. It is the same with circuit analysis. Just remember the key analysis that you will do, rest will follow by itself. Plus you will think, okay, you will think and do. Don't be afraid of the subject. Okay, anyway, let us go ahead, let us finish it. A, V, B finished. Based on question, next is AVS, okay? AVS, right? Now for AVS, again, I have to see the first circuit, the earlier circuit. What is expression for AVS? Answer. AVS. What is AVS? First place. You should be thorough. Even if I wake you up at night from sleep also, you should answer. Because so many times you have seen it. What is AVS? Expression. V naught. Please answer. Anybody. Quickly. What is AVS? V naught by? Four eighty seven Madan. Madan, you are not there. Should I write absent for Madan? 487 Madan, turn on your mic and answer.
Sir, yes, sir.
What is AVS, Madan? Madan, AVS, Madan. Are same story. Daily we are seeing. Daily I am telling same story. How you can forget that story? What is AVS? Madan, turn on your mic. 487 Madan, turn on your mic. What is AVS? Expression for AVS. Any circuit AVS is output voltage by source voltage. Okay. See, it is like this. Gain is output by input. Voltage gain is output voltage by input voltage. Okay. Gain, output by input. Voltage gain, output voltage by input voltage. Okay. AVS, A for gain, V for voltage, S considering source. Okay. So AVS is V naught by VS. Okay. AVS is V naught by VS. Okay. Already we found out V naught by VI. AV we found out. So let us use that and see V naught by VI. Into VI by VS will give V naught by VS. Okay. What I am trying to say is, as we have discussed several times, AVS is V naught by VS. Okay. So AVS is V naught by VS. Let us cross multiply, let us multiply and divide with VI. So V naught by VS, I can write it as V naught by VI multiplied by VI by VS. Okay. Why I want to do this? Because V naught by VI is what? What is V naught by VI? Answer please.
Voltage gain.
Yes, voltage gain already we derived. Okay. See, all my classes I want continuous answering. I keep on telling it is boring. Okay. Boring for you, boring for me, boring for those who are listening also. If